episode 5. And I've been wanting to do this one for a while. And again, I apologize for my absence. I've been sick. This one is called Shoot Your Shot, Swah. So by the time where I shot my shot in an interesting way and got that number down, let's talk about it. We're going to rewind this to 2007. It's one of my best years. Also, it's the year I released my first mixtape, original rap name, Swoop the Kid. This is called Number 86. This is my baby. This is my, I'm proud of this, still. And you're probably wondering, how the hell does my first mixtape tie into me shooting my shot and getting enough? Song number two, it's called I Got. Also, I was living in San Francisco at that time. My mixtape was the first that I ever did with the DJ Project. So shout out to the DJ Project. I'm forever grateful to you guys. But we're going to continue on with the story. Around this time, I had a day off. My homeboy called me up and was like, yo, what you doing? Come through. I'm about to have a get together. I'm like, fuck it. I'm here. Get dressed. Head to my homeboy house. It was him, our other homeboy, I believe his girlfriend at the time, and these two chicks, and one of them just caught my eye from the get-go. I was like, damn, who are you? I'm at my homeboy's spot. I'm looking like, damn, I'm over here patting him on the shoulder. Like, bro, who is that? He was like, oh, that's so-and-so. They're like, you think she cute, ain't you? I'm like, nah. They was like, nigga, stop lying. We know how you are. I'm like, damn, fuck. I think she cute, though. So, you know, did the basic stuff, introduced myself. My name is Francois. We got to chopping it up, you know. And then we started having fun. It was a get-together, goddammit. We eating, drinking, and talking shit. You know how black folk do. We having a good time. My folks was playing music. Some of the poppinest music in 2007, including Bay Area shit. Because this is when the hyphy movement was at its peak. So they look at me and say, yo, Francois, put your music in there. I'm like, me? I was like, yeah, put it in there. I said, all right. So I put it in there. Starting with this bad boy right here. And once we get from the first track, here's what I did at the second track. We playing the mixtape. Number two comes on, which is called I Go. We letting it play. And I just did this randomly. So I'm freestyling on the second verse over my own song. And while I'm freestyling, I'm asking baby girl for her number. And surprisingly, she gave your boy the digits. She was blown the fuck away. And when I tell you shock and awe, my people, I left my old squad in shock and motherfucking awe. Yes, I got the number. They were impressed. I was like, did that just happen? Did I just do that? It was like an out-of-body experience because I ain't never ever did no shit like that. But it worked. Unfortunately, me and old girl, you know, I didn't talk to her that long and I found out she did have a boyfriend this whole time. I was pissed because I really thought she was cute. I was spending, you know, movie dates. I was planning it all. But unfortunately, found out she had a boyfriend. My people found out she had a boyfriend. They was pissed. I was pissed. But life goes on. And now, words of wisdom. This is what I want y'all to do. I want you to pretend that this ball I'm holding is your confidence and in front of you is your crush, your MCM, your WCW, that person that every time that you think about them, they set your very essence on fire. And shoot that motherfucker. Shoot your shot, because tomorrow is not promised. Life is too short, and you don't want to have any regrets. As I'm getting older, into my 30s, I don't want to have no regrets. So shoot that motherfucker. Pretend this is the baseline and just shoot your shot. That's all it is to it. But to do it, I want to thank you for watching. As always, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe and hit the bell on the side of the subscription bar to be updated when I drop new content. The next episode of Storytime with Swah the Gentleman will be a Christmas story, actually. It'll be about one of these funny Christmas stories of my childhood that my mom likes to tell. So I figured I might as well bring it to the channel. Stay tuned and happy holidays.